Hello for Monday, April 2nd. We begin a new month. Maybe we'll get some inflows of money to finally get this market going. We had a dip, move back up, but not really that much change for the week before, although we'd hope for a quarter and a little bit more window dressing than we got, but we didn't get much. There's no new lows. You know, there's not many new lows in the market, so at the moment, it's just going sideways. Maybe we can still get a boost. I mean, things still look pretty positive. Anyway, no market charts today. Check the newsletter because they're all there. StockTiger.net, top right hand. There's a link to the newsletter with lots of information and some fun things also. So, addition to the watch list, here's a few longs yet to look for. We've got ALR. You can see the big boost in volume. Normally, it's around 500K shares a day, 1.3 million shares on Friday. It's going back up towards this 200-day EMA, which is at 26.38. And you can see this kind of resistance line too. That was basically the low the day that it went over the 200 day and then dropped back. So if we can go over there now, it'd be best if it went sideways a day and then ran up. But we'll see. We had some high movement and volume, but you can see in the past when it's done that, it has not as advanced. A lot of times it's just followed by a move a little bit lower, but we're adding that one. We'll watch and see if it can move above that area. BOE over about 1545 looks pretty good setup. It had some higher times as well, 1553, but I think this 45 area where we've got it is about right, maybe even 35, but it closed right at 35. So let's see if it can move out some more. It also had a bit of increased volume on Friday. 8x8 moved up over its 20-day EMA, and you note that it's trying to get that 20-day back over the 50. At the moment, 20 days at 410 and the 50 days at 411. So if that just moves up a little bit, one penny, two pennies, it'll be over it, and that's the right situation. Did have increased volume on Friday. It lost some of its gains. Think if it can get back over that 425 where we have the line, maybe we'll be in shape to move on up higher. GGP's up next. And there, what are we looking at? Let's get to the chart first. $17.07 looks to be the area. That's where the high was in March. And if we can better that, looks good. Volumes increased. We like that as well. IPXL is up next. There we've got $25. Looks to be about the place. $24.75 is what the high was in late February. And then it got to 25 on Friday and backed off. So if it can get back above that, we may get out of this range. It's been in the range for a month. And if it gets up, if you miss any of these types like this, they break out and then pull back to that area and hold it, that could be a buy as well. And True Religion Apparel, TRLG over 27.50. I'm thinking... it's not an exact figure, but you can see where it is. It went up about 27.47 on Friday, increasing volume. If it can get over that, the chance of it getting up to the 28.43, I think, are pretty good. That is the 50-day EMA, and you can see some resistance there. Then if it moves up above that over about 28.50, I think we could use that run as well to go up to the 29.84. That would be the 200-day, if it's been a long enough time for it to break into that gap, that is. So let's see how it goes. That's our additions to start off the week with. Thanks a lot for watching. Do check out the newsletter and, of course, the tweets. They'll be coming before the market opens on Monday and during the day as things develop. So thanks a lot. Have yourself a great week. See you soon. Bye.